welcome for today's video lecture of maths. As you know that we are dealing with chapter 4 factors and multiples, right? Yesterday we have solved the practice 4.5 which was based on the concept of factors, in which we have learned that factors of a number means what? For example, see, there is 10. So 10 can be expressed in the product of 2 into 5 or 1 into 10, correct? So these 1, 2, 5 and 10 are the factors of 10. Understood? This we have learned yesterday. So today we are going to solve practice 4.6, in which we are going to find the factors of the given numbers, okay? See the first question. Give all the factors of following numbers. There are 5 examples. We are going to take here 2. Remaining you have to solve by yourself. Okay. So the first example is 14. We have to find all the factors of 14. Remember the some things about factor C. Factors means what? Such numbers in which table the given number is there. Okay. That means what? We have to find such numbers in which table there is 14. Okay? So, when we are going to find the factors, first factor of every number or first pair of factor of every number is 1 and that number itself. Why 1 and that number itself? Because all the numbers are in table of 1. All the numbers, the numbers are uncountable, right? So all those numbers come in table of 1. And factors means what? Yes, the factors means the such numbers in which table the given number is there. Okay. So see here 40. While finding factors of 40, we have to write factors in the form of pair of the multiplication or product. Okay. So 40, first pair is always 1 into 1. Now 1 multiplied by how many 14? 1/14 is a 14, right? That means when we multiply any number with 1, it should be that number itself. 14 ones are 14, correct? 14 ones are 14. So this is the first pair of the factors of 14. After 1, is 14 in table of 2? Is 14 in table of 2? Yes, 2 into or 2 sevens are 14. 2 sevens are 14. Okay. Is it in table of 3? No. 4? No. 5 also no. 6 also no. So this much only. Then it is in table of 7. So we have got 7 here. That means there is no more factor, pair of factor of 14. Okay. So we have got here 2 pairs of factors of 14. That means 2 pairs of factors means in each pair there are 2 factors. 1, 14, 2 and 7. That means there are total 4 factors of 14. Okay. So that means 14 comes in table of 1, table of 2, table of 7 and table of 14 itself. 1, 14 is a 14, 2, 7 is a 14, 7, 2 is a 14, 14, 1 is a 14. Okay. Okay. So factors of 14 are 1, then 2, then 7 and 14 itself. Okay, these are the factors of 14. Understood? Similarly, let's find factors of 28. 28 is equal to the first pair of factors of 28 will be 1 into that number itself. 1 multiplied by the number itself, that is 28. Okay, 1 into 28. Because all the numbers come in the table of 1. Every number is a factor of, or every 1 is factor of every number. 1 is factor of every number. Because every number comes in table of 1, that means 1 is factor of every number. So the first pair is 1 into number itself. Okay. Second, now 28 is it in table of 2? So now see, when we say that it is in table of 2 or not, See, we recite table till 10s are, but tables are beyond that also. 2 11s are, 2 12s are, 2 13s are, 14s are, 15s are, okay? So see, 28. Now we have learned divisibility test. So you according to the divisibility test of 2, the last digit is 8 here. Last digit is 8. That means 28 is divisible by 2. That means 28 is in table of 2. Okay? So 28, if you divide 28 by 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. Correct? That means 14. 2 14s are 28. 2 14s are 28. Okay? Then, is it in table of 3? Now, 3 tens are 30, that means 30 is more than 28. So, this can be understand that whether 28 is in table of 3 or not. 3 nines are 27, 3 tens are 30, that means 28 is not then in table of 3. Is it in table of 4? Yes, 4 into 7. 4 sevens are 28. See, 1 28 are 28, 2 14 are 28, 4 7s are 28. Is it in table of 5? Is it in table of 6? No. Then it is in table of 7. So already we have got 7, that means all pair finished. So here we have got 3 pairs of the factors of 28. So factors of 28. F of 28 means factors of 28 is equal to 1, 2, 4, write in ascending order, 1, 2, 4, then 7, then 40, and 28 itself. Okay? So, here see, if you observe the factors of 40 and factors of 28, you will come to know that 1 is factor of 14 also, 1 is factor of 28 also. That means 1 is factor of all number. Also, 14 is factor of 14, 14 is factor of 14 itself, and 28 is factor of 28 itself. That means what? Every number is factor of that number itself. 100 can be factor of 100. 25 is factor of 25 itself. Okay, every number is factor of itself, and 1 is factor of all numbers. These two properties keep it in mind. In this question, first question, remaining 3 examples you have to do by yourself. Okay. In see question number 2, it is same. Give all the factors of following numbers that are less than the number itself. Now see here, if you observe factors of 1, 2, factors of 14, that is 1, 2, 7, 14, or factors of 28, that is 1, 2, 4, 7, 14, and 28, you will come to know that there is no any factor which is greater than the number. There is no any factor which is greater than the number. See, in the factors of 14, is there any factor which is greater than 14? 14 is factor of 14, it is equal to 14. But not greater, there is no any factor which is greater than 40. Okay? Here also see, last factor is 28, which is equal to 28. This number. So, the factor is not greater than the given number. If we have to find factors of 100, then the factors will be either less than 100 or equal to 100. Because 100 is factor of 100, so it is equal. And rest other factors will be less than 100. There is no any factor which is greater than the 100, right? So this is one of the property of the factors we can obtain. See, so all the factors of a number are either less than or equal to that number. There is no any factor which is greater than the number. Understood? So here see, we have to find all the factors of given number that are less than the number. So all the factors are less than number except only one factor, that is number itself. That we have to not write here. Okay. Rest of the process is same. Procedure is same. We have to find factors of 45 according to that method. Okay. So the first pair will be 1 into 45. See, for, I'm writing down the 45, but while writing like this here around, don't write this 45 because it is not less. It is equal to the 45 given number. So 45 will not write downside. Okay. Then 45, is it in table of 2? Is it divisible by 2? No. Is it divisible by 3? See, 4 plus 5, 9. Sum is 9 and 9 is divisible by 3. So, 45 is also divisible by 3. Now, 3 into what? 45. 3 into how many? For that, we will divide 45 by 3. 3 ones are 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. Take 5 down. 3 5s are 15. Okay. So, answer you got here? 15. So, that means for 15, 3s are 45. Or 3 15s are 45. Okay. The next. Is it divisible by 4? No, see, 4 tens are 40, 4 elevens are 40, 4 elevens, not 45. Is it divisible by 5?
Yes.
Now, 5, how many is that? 45. 5, 9 is 45. Okay. Is it divisible by 6? No, 6, 7 are 42, 6, 8 are 48. No, it is not there in table of 45. Not table of 6. 45 is not there in table of 6. Is it in table of 7? Again, no, because 7, 6 are 42, then 7, 7 are 49, there is no 45. Then it is it in table of 8? No. Then it is in table of 9, and 9 is written here. Okay? So, 5, 9 are 45, again 9, 5 are 45. Right? So, this is the last pair of the factors of 45. Now, factors of 45. While writing, we now see the question. What question is asked? We write all the factors of the given number that are less than the number itself. Less than the number itself. So in these factors, group of factors, there is only one number which is equal to the given number. So we don't have to write that. According to the instructions given in the question, we don't have to write this because we have to write all the factors which are less, smaller. Okay. So 1, then 3, 5, 9, and 15. 45 will not write here because it is equal, not smaller. Next, 48. So, 48 is in first there will be 1 into 48. Then there is, it is last digit is 2, that means it is divisible by 2. Now, 2 multiplied by how many 48? To find that, we need to divide 48 by 2. 2 2 is a 4. 2 4 is a 8. Okay, so answer is 24. 24 2 is a 48. Further, is it divisible by 8? Is it divisible by 3? So here see, you have to apply divisibility test of 3. Sum of the digit 8 plus 4, 12, right? 8 plus 4, 12. And 12 is divisible by 3. So 48 is also divisible by 3. Now 3 into how many 48? 3 into how many 48? 3 multiplied by how many? You know the table till 20, right? So you must know 3 into how many? Or which number multiplied by 3 gets 48? Immediately it should come in your mind. 16 3s are 48. If you divide 48 by 3, you will get answer 16. Okay, so 16 3s are 16 1 are 16, 16 2 are 32, 16 3s are 48. Fine. Then is it divisible by 4? Yes. 4 into 12 4s are 48. If you know the table, perfect. Immediately you will get the factors. 12 4s are 48. Then is it divisible by 5? No, last digit is not 0 or 5. It is 8, so it is not divisible by 5. Is it divisible by 6? Yes, 6, 8 is 48. Then is it divisible by 7? No, 7, 7 is 49, okay? Then it is divisible by 8, okay? From this side, we came this side, 8, 6 is 48. That means finished. So factors of 48. Factors of 48 which are less than 48 are just will not write this, just all factors will write. So here I write 24. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 16, and 24. Okay, so these are the factors of 48 which are less than it. Less than it, okay? We have not here written here 48 because it is equal to 48. It is not less. So, according to the question, okay? So, like this, these two questions we have solved. Remaining examples in both the questions you have to solve by yourself. Question number 3 and 4. There are two statements. That statements you write true or false, okay? So, I am going to explain the statement. First statement is, which number is factor of every number? Here this is what one word question, like question is given. which number is factor of every number. Now while discussing this, I have told you which number is factor of every number, or which all numbers come in table of which number? 1, right? So 1 is factor of every number. So write there 1. The next question is, can a factor of any number greater than that number? Can a factor of any number greater than that number? You have observed here, there is no any factor which is greater than that number. Okay? Factor is either equal or smaller, not greater. So write there no. There can, there no, can't, it can't be. Okay? So in this way, complete the practice 4.6. And if you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay? So thank you and have a nice day.